I'll go ahead and pop back to the Rahu K2 thing, and I just wanted to cover this. Subphotonic actually put out a video that everybody's been talking about Rahu and K2, but you know what he was talking about here was from Tet's Truth Tube, who is I believe here in Denver still, another YouTuber here in Denver, which is great, Flat Earther here in Denver. But he's looking at Tet's Truth Tube's video, and interestingly enough, he is finding, here it is right here, he's showing these seemingly dark bodies that are passing around the moon. And, you know, he's talking, as I covered the Rahu K2 and the Planet X, you know, a few weeks ago with Brother Sanchez, we're talking about how Rahu and K2 are basically two black bodies, and they're traveling at different velocities. And we have seen some very good footage from QNF and some other people from a few different angles on a eclipse viewing aircraft, right? And we've seen these little balls that are out there that, you know, that are very interesting. And this is also what I'm hoping to pick up, you know, during the eclipse here. But and I realize that even with the OBS, this may be a little bit difficult to see. But he shows, let's get to it here, actually. You can actually see these bodies kind of go by the moon and the sun. Yeah, there it is right there. So we'll let him go it. So it's going to come from the top. You can see it's going across the top. And Rahu is already half eclipsing it, and K2 kind of whips by it at a relatively high velocity. And what we're witnessing here, believe it or not, goes perfectly well with the description in Vedic cosmology about the nature of Rahu and K2, which I find very interesting. And people, I'm sure the baller is going to look at this and go, oh, that's just some sort of lens flare or whatever. And if you can't see it, hopefully you can, but if you can't, it looks like it's showing on the monitor very well. God, I love OBS. But if you can't, I will have all these links in the desktop. But, you know, we're definitely seeing some other body that's going around there multiple times, and you can't just say, well, this is some sort of a lens aberration, because then you would have to explain exactly what it's coming from and why it's moving at that velocity. So this obviously is nothing conclusive, but it's just another piece of evidence that you want to, you know, kind of look at that. And I do believe this. I do believe that there are absolutely other bodies up there, black bodies that have been described in several cosmologies, as well as Samuel Robotham even discussed them, and talking about that this is what was causing the eclipse. In fact, here it is, the quote from Zetetic Astronomy. So it's pretty amazing, and I think that if we can get a bunch of people capturing this in August, and we actually are able to see some of these black bodies, that would be awesome. Because I don't believe this is the moon for a second. And secondly, you have to wonder yourself, the sun is still shining on the Earth, so the Earth's shine is way brighter than the moonshine, right? So it should be reflecting, and it should be lighting up the side of the moon that we see instead of it just being dark. That makes absolutely no sense that we're not seeing anything other than just a black body, because the moon has a much higher reflectivity. And what is the technical term for it called? Not libido. Do you know what, I'm trying to say, Jeremy?
Lumination or
Well, anyway, albedo. There it is. I'm sorry.
Libido, albedo.
Yeah, libido. Has a much better libido. But, yeah, so we should be seeing absolutely the front side of that moon just from the Earth shine. Do we see it? Never. Ever do we see it. And that makes absolutely no sense. And here we are. We're seeing this translucent body pass behind the moon again. You know, where you've got Rahu eclipsing it, and then you've got K2 running behind it, assuming that's what it is. But if it isn't, then we need to have an explanation for what we're seeing here and why it's traveling at that speed, because it's not just an aberration that's going to come out of nowhere. There's going to have to be something that is actually causing this. And I don't think that NASA is quite prepared to make that explanation.